Good morning, guys. Today we are going thrift shopping and just having a mental health day for mama. I'm gonna meet up with my mom and just go to a bunch of thrift shops and have some lunch with her. We actually weren't supposed to do this date until next week, but days off with my husband and stuff switched around, and last night we decided that we are going today. So I'm very excited to be out of the house. It has been much needed, just caregiving and obviously the holidays and cleaning up from the holidays and just starting a brand new year off to a good start with a fresh mind. And the babes are going to be getting their new rooms soon. They're gonna have their own rooms. They've been sharing this entire time, and the time has come when, not quite yet, it'll take a little bit of time, but the time is coming to where they're going to have their own spaces. And so I don't have a ton of plans on what to get. As far as this trip goes, I do have a little list in mind. I always look for like baskets, picture frames, books, stuff like that are always on my list when I go thrifting. But specifically this trip, I'm just trying to see if there's anything that stands out to me for their new bedrooms. So I'm just gonna take you along today. I'm not sure what it's all going to entail, but yeah, I'm excited to get some fresh air, have some mama time, have some me time. I'm a very creative person, and this is just one of my outlets. And so I encourage you, as a new year that comes with change, please do not be afraid of change, but stick with your style and don't be afraid to share your style. You know, things happen in life and you may need to adjust, you know, what you purchase or what you have in your home and stuff like that, but that doesn't mean your style has to change. I feel like I've lost my style over the past couple years, just having babies and, you know, being sucked into just being a new mama and stuff like that again. But my style really hasn't changed, but my home has just been stagnant. Like, I have not enjoyed decorating and like rearranging and stuff that I normally like to do with our home. So this year I'm very excited to just get a jump start on that again and refresh spaces and just make it part of our story again and really love and appreciate the home that we live in, the chapter that we're in, and all that we have and have been given. So I also want to say that it's okay to change your style too. I'm going through a stage of trying to figure out like my wardrobe and stuff again, and just figuring out who I am as a person other than just being a mom. So my style all around, I would say, is being refreshed, and I wouldn't say that it's changing. I'm just getting down to the nitty gritty on what I like to wear and what specific things I like to gravitate towards when I'm shopping. I don't get to go shopping very often, I would say, but thrift days are very exciting for me. So find something that's exciting for you and make sure you put it on your calendar in this new year. Maybe not once, maybe a couple times. So anyways, I just grabbed a local coffee from our coffee shop. She wrote a little message, "Choose to have a great day." So we are going to do just that. And I'm gonna head to mom's. I'm not going to her house. I'm actually just gonna meet her like in town by where her thrift shops are. So I'm just gonna head there now, and then I'll catch up with you at some point while we're shopping. Okay guys, we made it to our first stop. I just parallel parked for the first time in years. Like, I couldn't even tell you how long, and that's only because I choose not to parallel park. Did a really good job. I'm lined up with the other car. I did not hit the car, and I'm within the lines, so go me. Anyways, I made it here a little bit before mom, so our first stop per her request was the coffee shop because she needs a coffee, and I am ready for my second one of the day, so I guess it all works out. So anyway, coffee shop first, and then we shall see what shops catch my eye. The first one opens at 10 and it is currently 9:30, so we're just gonna go in and chit chat for a little bit. And then she said most of them are on this main drag, so we're really not going to go too far, which is nice. because if we find some goodies, we can just take them right back to the car and not have to, you know, go too far with them. And I did bring my like reusable bags too, just because, you know, if you need to put more than one bag into one big bag, I would rather carry it that way than a bunch down the street. So mom said she's almost here and then we'll go in for another cup of joe. Look, you got to pull work too.
Man, actually I could even have fallen back more.
Wow, look at you.
Oh, boy.
We've been wanting to do this forever.
So excited. Get this tree. It's all pine cones. I'm obviously going to take this tinsel thing off, but it makes for a good winter decor after Christmas is done. Oh, he's so cute too. I don't even know why we were in this section right now. We should not be in this section. Christmas is over. Mom and I think he's gonna jump up at any moment. No, he just snores. That's pretty cute. Jude would love that. Do we like this?
Sand it down and everything, but it's cute. Neighbor next to us in Arizona.
We had those.
What was her name? The old lady next to us.
Trudy.
Trudy.
Yeah.
She had this entire set.
Did she really?
Yeah.
Well, I already have her quilt, so yes. I feel like you need a part of her.
Well.
cute this rocker is with the birds on it.
$28. It is sold.
Randy would not be allowed to sing that.
No, or Papa Paw. Sorry, I just got aggressive.
Should we carry it up to the front?
You know what he would say? Go ahead, Mom. I'll just stay here and wait for you.
Come back and get me, Mom. I'm okay.
Yeah, this is exactly where he would sit. Look at the old school raisins.
This is the topper to something. Oh, too pretty.
Look at the little Bambi. That's precious. Mom, here's another one of those arches like I have at my house.
Oh, yeah.
$17.50.
I don't know where I would put it, but I love it. I'll have to think about it. I don't have that much space, but I'm ready to like just move things around.
Oh my gosh, I love this.
Says there should be three of them. Did you not see two others?
Yeah,
we did.
Mom, we did good.
This has been so fun.
This is so fun. Okay, so we're waiting for the train to pass, so we thought we'd do a little check-in of the day.
And we're scoring.
We scored big time.
Like, look in the back. And this ain't even...
A little sneak peek.
This ain't even...
That shelf. Oh my gosh. I can't wait to show you all the things. I think we did pretty good because we're doing two rooms. Jude and Ren's room. Hey, look how cute she is. Her cane even matches her outfit. So we're going to go grab some lunch and what are we doing now? Do we have another place?
And then we're going to look for a couple more that's down here before... We depart.
Okay. Don't say that.
I know.
Yeah. Okay. So we'll check back in soon.
Oh, It's just for a kid's room.
Yeah, have fun.
Remember Teddy Ruxpin?
Yes. That's been there for a while. Every time I come in here, I always think of you.
Oh, thanks.
Look at this thing, Shelby. For Jude.
Oh my God. He would have a field day on that.
Uh-huh. I had this when I was a girl. Believe it or not.
When you were a girl.
When I was a little girl.
Best. It's a plane?
Yeah. It says ship. It was a plane. It was the plane.
Oh my
God. Oh my gosh. This is the best. This is fun. Rock and sock and robots.
Yeah. Jude would have a field day.
Holding on to that silver thing and putting your feet on the pegs.
That sounds like you've experienced before.
Yes.
Oh my gosh, a slingshot.
Mm-hmm. Right?
Okay, so we've made it home. We are done with our thrifting. It was such a fun day. Thanks for going with Mom and I. I am sitting in this empty room that is soon to be Jude's room. So if it's a little bit echoey, I'm sorry about that. And I don't have everything that I got in front of me here. Some of the bigger pieces I just kind of left in the garage. And there are other pieces I know that are put away. Some of them were Christmas items, which were like, you know, 75% off on the day that we went. So I'll kind of tell you a little bit on some things that I got that aren't here, but otherwise I'm just going to kind of shift through real quick and show you some of our favorite things that I got. For doing two bedrooms, I totally scored and I picked up things that I definitely did not think I was going to pick up. So yeah, just always keep an open mind when you go thrifting. You never know what you're gonna find, but it's always a good idea to go with kind of a set plan in mind. Otherwise you can definitely feel overwhelmed. I had a set plan on things that I knew that I needed for their rooms and picked up a few extra things, but I wouldn't say any of the things are unnecessary. And if I can't use them in their rooms, it's definitely things that I go towards to use throughout our home anyway. So I added up everything once I got home. I spent just under, it was like $290 something, just under $300 for everything. That's two bedrooms. And like I said, a few extra of the big pieces, I definitely did not think I was going to find. One of the bigger pieces that we fell in love with was a little rocker. It had stunning fabric already on it, some little birds. Our daughter's name is Wren, so just anything with little birds here and there, I just love to kind of incorporate within our home or within her room. It was just a dainty little rocker. It definitely would not hold Dad on it by any means, but something cute in the corner of her room I had been kind of looking for. And again, this fabric just kind of stood out to me as needing to be in there. I just think it's gonna be the perfect little piece for her room. So we did end up getting that and we were so excited to see that it was only $28. I could not even believe that. And Mom thinks that it got tagged that on accident. Like it should have been maybe $128 or I don't know. Sometimes in booths though, they're trying to just get rid of things fast and they definitely will mark them down like that. But we were so excited to see how low the price was on that. So we did snag that pretty quick. Another big item that we got was a twin bed frame. I kind of have bed frame ideas in mind for these two rooms. And it wasn't something that I would say I absolutely loved. It's also not something that I felt like I settled on and it was cheap enough to kind of just grab it and see if it's going to work. So I got a twin bed frame for, I think it's going to be Ren's room, and my plan is to add some little molding pieces and make it a little more feminine, and then we are going to paint it. So that'll be a fun little project to do for her. But that again was one thing that I did not plan on looking for or purchasing. Anyways, I'm just gonna kind of skim through pretty quick here, and each item that I saw kind of had its own little place in mind on where I was gonna put it in our home immediately. Otherwise, I knew in the back of my mind that it was going to be put to use. So none of these things I settled on. I definitely fell in love with the idea of where it could go specifically, and I'm just gonna jump right in. So the first one, as you saw me post about, was this beauty. I loved the frame. It's definitely something you can touch up if you wanted to, but I loved the second layer of linen texture here. You don't really find that on too many vintage frames, so whenever I do, I kind of snag it. This is like an original painting here, and just the colors of it just kind of flow with the color scheme of our home, so I knew it was going to go in many places. I kind of have an idea for it, but if it doesn't fit there, then I have two backup plans. So she's a beaut, and I had to bring her home with me. Okay, the next piece of furniture I got was this little stool for Ren's room. It has a beautiful fabric on it. It is in good shape, like it's pretty sturdy. One of the legs is a little bit wobbly, I don't know which one, but it can definitely be fixed. And down here, it's pretty scuffed up, but I do want to see how it goes in her room like this. Otherwise, I may sand the legs and kind of make them lighter and bring them to life again with this fabric. But I do love this fabric. I'm hoping that it goes with the flow of her room once it's kind of all put together, but I couldn't resist just having a little stool for her in there. Okay, another thing that I found, which you guys saw a video clip already, is this shelf. It's just a dainty little shelf. I liked the color of it originally, and again, I'm gonna see how it goes in his room, but we are gonna have accents of green in Jude's room, so I mean, if anything, I can paint it the way I need to, but it just kind of caught my eye, and it's just another place to kind of put some things up on a higher level, and I liked the idea of the hooks as well. If these get a little bit too iffy in my toddler's room, then I will switch them out with some other antique hooks that I have for now, but I liked the idea of it. We will see how it turns out. Okay, so another thing I imagined for Ren's room, and I'm gonna post an inspiration picture here because this is not what it looks like, but it is this dainty little wreath with a bunch of ribbon tied around it just to make it more feminine, and some baby's breath, which this one already came with. So my plan is to take off of this Christmassy stuff, and I found my dainty little wreath that I wanted for her room. I do have a few of these stick wreaths on hand already, but they are in a bigger size. So I just got so excited when I found this little one because that's what I want to put in her room. Okay, I picked up those little flash cards. I believe I had a video clip of this. Yes, so they just came in bundles, and they're different words here, but with teaching the kids at home, you know, how to read and letter sounds and stuff like that. And also just for decor, like these are just so cute and simple just to put around the house when needed, and you can switch them out. There's seasons and just little inspiration cards. I just love them. I stick them in my old little flower frogs, and again, they make for cute decor, if anything. I found these two little baskets. And so for Ren's room, her birthday is coming up here in February. So you will see another vlog about kind of prepping for her birthday stuff and whatnot. One of the things that I have found for her is a little childhood's cupboard, which I'm gonna turn into like a little kitchen set for her. So that again is in the garage as well, so I can't just easily show that to you right now, but I'm gonna get some vintage knobs to put on, and we already got like a little phone to put on the side of it, so I'm pretty excited about that. So some of these items that I have purchased, I kind of imagined like being on the cupboard or like next to it for her to play house with. These again can go anywhere in my home as well if I decide not to use them in the kids' rooms, but I found these two baskets with lids. And lidded baskets are always nice just because you can kind of hide more things and it looks more aesthetically pleasing rather than things sticking out of it all the time. So I got excited when I found those. To go with Ren's kitchen set thing, I also found this little shelving unit that'll go right next to it. It is so precious. It is literally the height of the children's cupboard, so it's shorter. It's made out of the same boho rattan material that I also have like a twin headboard out of. I don't know if I'm going to use the twin headboard as her bed, but I thought about putting that even like behind the kitchen cupboard somehow as like wall decor, and then this would kind of flow next to it. But this is the most precious thing ever. Let me see if I can turn you a little bit here. Again, it is children's size, so it is shorter than like what I would want to use like in another part of our house per se. But it is very precious and I just can't wait to see it all put together. And I already know she's gonna love it. When I brought that in, I actually put it into the kitchen at first and kind of put some of their old like play food and stuff on it just to have a place to put it because I didn't want to leave it out in the garage. And they were already playing with it. So I already know like they're just gonna love it when it's all put together. These little frames I got with the thought of putting some rub and buff on it just to kind of go with the flow of our home. But I originally thought to put them next to her kitchen set as well and just put like some family pictures in it or a picture of her or something. So it feels like her little house set up. So again, I can always reuse these somewhere else when we are done with them in her room, or if they don't look right, you can add magnets on the back and use them as fridge magnets, which I have recently done with some others and I just love it. So I just have a lot of ideas in mind if things don't work out. This little basket is specifically for Jude because he loves to like hide little things. He's a total like Indian in the cupboard little boy and I love that about him. So Nana found this one that kind of opened and closed and we were both like, okay, that's for Jude. So that's just kind of like a little goodie for him when we redo his room. Some of the things, like I said, that I don't have here are more Christmas items. So I did get like two of these for 50 cents to go on the kids' trees next year. They're each gonna have trees in their own room now. So this kind of stuff is just great to have for the next year coming. So we got that. I did end up getting that pine cone tree with the tassel around it. I took the tassel off and that is just a statement piece that you can use for Christmas time or even winter time because it's just pine cones, so it doesn't scream Christmas. And I just love that. I found this picture stand. It was definitely on my list to look for. Jude has this giant like wooden puzzle. It's more of an heirloom puzzle that I purchased for him and it's dinosaurs, which he loves right now, but it's definitely something that will last him a long time and it's something that you can display because it's just so unique and cool. So I wanted to get a stand for it. This is just another basket I found that's perfect for probably around the house. I don't know if I'll use this in either of their bedrooms per se, but just great for organizing around the house. Okay, here is that little shelf like empty now. If you wanna see a little better view of it, and it's just so cute. Oh my gosh, I can't wait to show you when it's all finished. Another idea that I had for each of their rooms was to eventually have a basket hanging off the footboard of their bed, just for like a little bedtime book and a stuffed animal, just kind of the look of like bedtime scene. So this is the one I found for Jude. It's the flat on one side, and then we will just hang it on the side of his bed with something hanging out of it. But it did have some fun boyish colors on there, and he's not gonna have a very colorful room, but the green ties in, and then hints of the other colors will definitely look good too. So okay, another thing I picked up for Ren's room was just this cute little swan girl. I'm not sure what I'm gonna do with her yet, but just up on her shelf filled with something is just gonna be so fresh. I just knew that she had to come home with us. Okay, so here are some baskets that I got. I think I showed this one. I didn't end up getting that first basket that I showed in the thrifting day because it just ended up being like not the vibe at the end that I wanted. My tip for you though is whenever you go thrifting, you put whatever you're thinking about in your cart. You can always decide later to put it back. But if you decide while you're walking around that, yes, I really do want it, and then you go back and it's not there anymore, that's not fun. Always put what you think you want in your cart. And that for me that day was that first basket that I saw. I love the idea of it. I love the shape of it. I love the oldness of it. I love the colors on it. But with the colors on it, I just kept going back and forth, like if it would truly like go with the vibe that I wanted. So I ended up putting that one back. Here are a couple baskets I got. Again, this can be used like carrying something or not. But I have lots of these baskets around our house for organizing toys and just different things. So here's just a little white one that I also found. This one is in a little bit rougher shape, but it did have some pastel pink handles on it. And I just thought this was perfect for her to like, you know, be rough with and play with however she wanted. I ended up getting those two matching baskets because the look of matching baskets is so cute. So I imagined these originally to go into Jude's room on the shelving unit that I'm going to do. And I still think they will look cute in there, but we'll see the vibe, and if not, two matching baskets will go perfect somewhere else in my home. So this is the most precious darling basket ever. So I got that one, and I got this giant one, which you can never go wrong with a big sturdy basket like this. My vibe is usually to find them without a handle, so they're more just like the bottom part, obviously, but it doesn't hurt to have a handle too. Usually when we go out to the clubhouse or something to play, I'm always looking for something like this to throw all of our drinks and snacks and extra play toys that we need to head out there. And this is a giant sturdy one, so I'm excited for that to come to life into our home. It'll get lots of love, I know that. So I guess we can just do books now. I usually do find a lot of good books thrifting. If you go to the children's book section, they have all sorts of things. This trip was more definitely like old school thrifted books. And this isn't something that I would leave out like all the time, but within a toy rotation or when I am with them to kind of pin through a little bit easier on the pages and still have fun with it, but not just let them kind of tear into it. And some of them will grow older with them too, which is nice. This first one you saw my mom kind of pan through at the store, and it's just in such good shape and it's just beautiful. It was only $2, but the reason I got the Snow White one, there was a Cinderella one too, which I kind of wish I would have gotten, but the reason I get drawn to Snow White is Wren just kind of reminds me of my little Snow White. She has dark hair, blue eyes, you know, she has that kind of a vibe to her. So Snow White has always kind of stuck out to me when I think of her, and this book was just beautifully colored, and I think it'll be fun for her to read with us. I definitely think it'll be a fun one to read together, and I know the boys will like it too. I picked up this one because how can you not? It's just such a little staple to have. I picked up this one because I know as Jude gets older, he's gonna love this. Oh, 1001 Riddles for Children. So I was skimming through this and it's so much fun. It's just one of those where they have all of the riddles and like numbered off and stuff. And then in the very back are all the answers. So you kind of go back and forth to tell the joke and the answer. And I just know between Jude and Dad and myself, who am I kidding? Like, we're gonna have fun with this as he gets older. The colors of it and the oldness of it, it just looks so cute, like sitting up on his bookshelf, so. Okay, and then these were the two super old ones, which again, I don't know how like I'll display this or anything like that, but I know that we'll get some use out of it. Look how beautiful these are. And they're the basic nursery rhymes, so my kids already know these. And it's not that easy to rip apart. They're like linen pages. It's just beautiful, but I just got it for fun. Again, it was what, probably a dollar or so. So I picked that up. And this is for when they get a little bit older, but this will be a fun little activity to do at the table while I am helping them. But it is Raggedy Ann and Andy paper dolls. It's definitely old, but definitely still fun. I know that we can get a little bit of use out of these. It comes with all of the original pieces. I've went through it already and oh, so precious. So those were just some fun books. If you look in the book section though, there are definitely like non super old vintage books. There's like everyday books that you can pick up for your kids, and I do it all the time and replace their bookshelves and give them a fresh new look. So that's always fun. The last couple things I got here were some pillows. Jude is going to have a chair in his room. I'm not sure what chair yet. I don't know if we're just gonna move one we already have in here or what, but he needed a pillow on his chair and I came across this one. And it's definitely not brightly colored. It is a very worn out and textured pillow, and that's what I love about it. And I can just picture this like in a little boy's room. So whether it's on his bed and, you know, you can rotate things around. I don't know if I'm gonna put it on his bed or in his chair yet, but we'll see. And then I got two of these pillows because I didn't know if I was going to put both in Owen's room or one in Jude's room and one in Owen's room. I don't know. You can always move pillows around, but I got two of these. They were at a very good cheap price. And I've already washed them and I loved the leather on the bottom. I feel like that's what kind of gives that old look to it. This kind of threw me off, but this is what grounded me. So we're gonna make these look cute. Okay, I'm looking around and I think I showed you everything that I have up here. Again, there's a few pieces that have already been put away because it's Christmas and the bigger pieces are out in the garage now, waiting to be like freshened up and brought in once the rest of these bedrooms are cleared out and ready. Oh my gosh, I found some extra things that I forgot I bought for Ren's room. These little wooden birds came in a few, is it upside down to you? Yes. These wooden birds came in a few different sizes and I thought how beautiful would those be just up on her wall. I don't know where I'm gonna put them yet. I don't know if it's gonna be by her bed or by her little kitchen area, but it's gonna be so cute. And again, they're birds, so it's just a little hint of my little Ren bird in there. And then I found I think a couple came with this. Couple little like wooden floral pieces as well to incorporate. And again, if I don't like them in her room, I can put them like in my bathroom or something too. So they'll definitely get use out of it. But okay, that is the last thing that I see. So if you've made it this far, thank you so much again for thrifting with us and sticking through this long video to see all the sweet treasures that I found for my baby's rooms. Just keep in mind, you don't always have to have everything new. Thrifted items are just as good as brand new items sometimes, and old treasures brought back to life are just my total jam. So if you can find the love in thrifting, I hope that you're able to find some pieces for your home, save a little bit of money, enjoy it in a brand new atmosphere, and make it your own. So if you guys follow us, you know that Owen has been sick lately. So we've been a little bit busy with that per se. We're kind of in survival mode, but this was definitely a fun mental health day for me to get out of the house, do something I love. I'm definitely looking forward to doing more of it this year and just making it intentional. This is a very intentional year coming and an intentional life happening afterwards as well. So thank you so much for going on this fun mental health day with me and seeing all of our goodies, and I'll see you again soon when I put everything together. Bye guys.